We'll see how to convert fractional numbers which are in decimal to binary. Example, you have 1.25 base 10. How to convert it into binary? Before that, I will tell you one important fact. When you have, you know, numbers or digits at right side of point, they also will be having weightages, but in a model like this, 10 power minus 1, 10 power minus 2, so on. That means 1.25 can be written as 1 means 10 to the power of 0 into 1 plus 2 means 10 to the power of minus 1 into 2 plus 5 will be having 10 power minus 2 weightage. Okay. Example, if you have 23.45, that can be written as, see, already this part you know, this means 10 power 0 weightage, this is 10 power 1 weightage, right? So 10 power 1 into 2 plus 10 to the power of 0 into 3 plus 10 to the power of, sir, what about this one, sir? Yes, I'm coming to that point. So 4 is going to get a weightage called 10 power minus 1, 5 is going to get a weightage 10 power minus 2. So that is the way, you know, this number system is built. So 10 power minus 1 into 4 plus 10 power minus 2 into 5. Then it would be 2 tens of 20 plus 3 into 1, 3 plus 10 power minus 1 means 1 by 10, 4 by 10 plus this is 5 by 100. If you simplify it, you get 20 plus 3, 23 plus 4 by 10 actually we write 0.4, right? Plus 5 by 100 will be 0.05. 0.4 plus 0.05, 0.45. 23 plus 0.45, 23.45. Isn't it in that way? So 23.45 can be perceived, right? This rule will be applicable for binary also. When you have binary number, while conversion, you can use this, you know, formula. Remember it. Now we'll come to conversion part. How to convert a fractional number to which is in decimal to binary? Take like this 1.25 base 10. So target 1. First of all, we see how to convert 1 into binary. We know that directly it is 1. Right? Done. Keep point as it is. Now we are going to convert 0.25 first of all into binary, and we are going to write here. How to convert 0.25 to binary, I will tell you, which is base 10, right? The idea will be like this. So rather than dividing, so this time we are not dividing 0.25 by 2. We multiply 0.25 into 2. What is the answer? 0.5. So now here this part is 0, right? Then remember that is 0. Next, take remaining part 0.5. So 0.5 and multiply with 2. 0.5 into 2, 1. Whenever you get 1, then this 1 should be remembered like this. In that way, we have to remember always this portion. Now take this part again, 0.0. 0.0 into 2 will be 0.0, right? Then you take 0. Then we can repeat this process. Any number of times you repeat, you are going to get 0.0. Then 0.1000, right? Again, same thing. We have to take from bottom to top. It would be what? You know, sorry. You have to take from top to bottom this time. I'm sorry. Top to bottom. When you take top to bottom, you get 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, so on. Okay. These are all meaningless. That means, you know, not meaningful. Yeah, we'll see the second one. 3.625 base 10. It's in the same model. 3.625. First, convert 3 into binary. We know the procedure. You get 1, 1, correct? Then point. So 0.625 has to be converted to binary. The technique is like this. First of all, multiply every time the number into 2, correct? So you get 0.625 into 2, which is nothing but 1.25. Of course, 0. 1.250. So here, when you do that, this area or this point is nothing but to be remembered. 1. Now remaining thing is what? 0.25. Take 0.25 into 2 again. When you do that, you get 0.5. So this 0 goes here. Then this remaining portion, 0.5, will come here. So 0.5 into 2. It would be 0.5 into 2 is 1. Correct? That means 1.0. Take this 1. And the remaining area is 0. Right? Take this 0. 0.0. Then stop it. Because any number of times you continue, then you will be getting 0.0 and the, you know, this remainder will be 0, I can say. So these zeros are useless, otherwise, you know, that will not add any weightage to the number. That's why it would be 101 followed by any number of zeros. It's like, you know, example, you have 2.3000, second one 2.30, both are same, isn't it? So that's fine. In the fractional part, the non-leading zeros are meaningless, correct? That's a thing. It would be 11.101000, so on. We can ignore these zeros, I want to say. Next, 7.375 base 10. In the same way, let us do that. 7 means 111 point. So remaining part is 0.375. We have to convert this to binary. First step, 0.375 into 2, which is 0.750. So here it is 0.750. 0 is remainder. Remember that 0. Then remaining thing is 0.750 into 2, which is 1.5, correct? 1.5. So remember 1. Next remaining part 0.5. 0.5 into 2, you get 1.0. Remember 1 and take this one, 0.0 into 2, 0.0. This is again never ending process. So you get zeros here. So we can ignore that part. So only this part is important. 011. 011. Okay. Don't ignore this 0. This is important. But this ending zeros are unnecessary. In that way, we can convert any number which is in decimal to binary when you have fractional numbers. Understand? Now, sometimes what happens, you can't represent with finite number of bits. Example, in decimal, I will show. When you have 1 by 3, what is the decimal representation for this one? 0.3333333. So how many digits you require to represent 1 by 3? Infinite. Without infinite positions, we can't represent 1 by 3 exactly, right? So in the same way in binary also, we have such patterns. I will show that. Example, let's say you have 0.2 base 10. Whatever the way you try, whatever the positions you take, you can't represent it. I will show that. Example, try to convert this into, you know, binary. We will see. Because this, you know, integer part is 0, then in binary also 0. I'm converting into binary. The remaining part 0.2, correct? Take 0.2 into 2. 0.2 into 2, 0.4. Then remainder 0. Then 0.4 into 2, 0.8. Remainder 0. 0.8 into 2, 1.6, right? So 1 is the remainder. The remaining part 0.6. 0.6 into 2, 1.2. Reminder 1. Remaining part 0.2. See, when 0.2 comes, if you do the process, that will be repeated again. 0.4, right? You get again 0. Then 0.4 into 2, 0.8, you get again 0. 0.8 into 2, you get 1.6. So remainder 1, then 0.6 here. 0.6 means 1.2. So again you get remainder 1, then you get 0.2. See, here and here and here, that process will be repeated. It's a never ending story. Then you get 0.0011 0011. This 0011 pattern will be repeated again and again. So infinite bits are required here also to represent this 0.2 base 10. That means some of the numbers cannot be represented with finite positions. That you should understand. Like in decimal, we have 1 by 3, right? So this is about conversions from, you know, your decimal to especially binary when you have fractional numbers. Okay, see this one, 123.456 base 8 equal to dash base 10. Okay, so how to convert? So far we have seen for binary, right? Now we'll see for this octal. Very simple, same idea. The weightages will be like this. It would be 8 square, this is 8 power 1, this is 8 power 0, and this would be 8 power minus 1, 8 power minus 2, 8 power minus 3 in that way. So this will be extended to any number of digits. Then if I convert, it would become 64 into 1 plus 8 into 2 plus 8 power 0, 1 into 3 plus 4 by 8 plus 5 by 8 square plus 6 by 8 power 3. In that way, we have to simplify. Then if you simplify it, you get decimal, right? Second thing, if you have octal, how to convert it into binary? Example, let's say you have something 0.1, 0.777. when you have 0.777 in octal, okay, what I would like to tell you is it is equivalent to 0.111111111 base 2. These two are equivalent. So from now onwards, why it is equivalent, we'll see with some example. But before that, you see how to, you know, convert binary to octal, especially, you know, this decimal numbers are fractional numbers. See, take from right side, take each and every 3 and convert them to, you know, octal. So 111 is 7, 111 is 7, 111 is 7. That's why it is equivalent to 0.777 octal. Okay. So why these two are equivalent, if you want to know, then you should know the, you know, simplification process. See, what I can do is, first of all, try to convert this to decimal. So you will understand everything. If I convert it into decimal, so 7. 7 means 7 by 8, correct? So this would be 7 by 8 square. This would be 7 by 8 cube. This is the way we convert, you know, this octal to decimal, right? Try to convert this to decimal. It would be, you know, first of all, I am converting this area. It would be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 square plus 1 by 2 cube. Right. Then this would be 1 by 2 to the power of 4 plus 1 by 2 to the power of 5 plus 1 by 2 to the power of 6. Correct? Plus 1 by 2 to the power of 7 plus 1 by 2 power 8 plus 1 by 2 power 9. Why these two are equivalent, we are going to see. Let us focus on this area. So here what I am doing is, because we need 8, right? I will take 1 by 2 cube common in this first component. Then you get what? If I take 1 by 2 cube common, here you get 4, plus here you get 2, here you get 1. Right, now try to understand. 1 by 2 cube into 4 plus 2 plus 1, which is nothing but, you know 7. That is a binary, octal equivalent of 111. Similarly here, if you have this area, this can be represented as 1 by 2 power 6 I take common this time, then it would be same story. 1 by 2 power 6 if I take common here, you get 1 by, 2 square, 2 square into 1, 4. Try to understand. 4 by 2 power 6, just take it out. 4 by 2 power 6 is 2 square by 2 power 6, which is nothing but 1 by 2 power 4, right? So that's why 1 by 2 power 4 is nothing but 4 by 2 power 6 plus this would be 2 by 2 power 6 plus this would be 1 by 2 power 6 as it is. So again you have 4 plus 2 plus 1, right? So next time if I take 1 by 2 to the power of 9 common here, you get here again 4 plus 2 plus 1. So in this process you understand finally, it is nothing but, this binary representation is nothing but 1 by 2 cube into 111's value plus 1 by 2 power 6 into this binary value in the octal form and 1 by 2 power 9 into this 4 plus 2 plus 1 in octal form. That means, so 1 by 2 cube into this weightage, 111. What is the value of 111? 7. So what is the value of this 111? 7. So what is the value of this one? 7. It is like 7 into 1 by 2 cube plus 7 into 1 by 2 power 6, which is nothing but 8 square, 64. This is 8. So here this would be 1 by, 8 cube, 512 into 7. See, 1 by 8 into 7 plus 1 by 8 square into 7 plus 1 by 8 cube into 7, equivalent, right? So this is what happens actually. That's why these two values are equivalent. From now onwards, we remember them blindly. That, of course, you know, with some general variables I can prove, but that is not really required. That's why I did not do that. I'm just explaining you the reasoning behind why these two are equivalent. Okay, from now onwards, whenever you have something 0.5243 in octal, and if you want to convert it into binary, simply do this process. That's why 0.5, this 5 is octal digit, should be converted to binary. 101, 2 is nothing but 010, 4 100, 3 0111. So these two are equivalent, whatever these two. In that way, so from octal to binary, binary to octal we can convert. Similarly, we can convert from octal to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to binary. Everything we can do now with this one. So finally, we have understood how to, you know, represent all unsigned numbers, correct? whatever it is. Unsigned numbers can be classified into two parts, some in integers, okay, positive integers of course, and of course non-negative integers otherwise. So we already see non-negative integer representation, then after that fractions, correct, how to represent fractions in unsigned. Okay, so let me remove this non-negative. Unsigned means there is no negative values, right, automatically. So unsigned integers we have seen, unsigned fractions we have seen, and various conversions from, you know, one base to another base we have seen. Now you know how to convert from each base to another base, correct? Yes. Now we will be seeing how to, you know, represent negative numbers. So far we have seen positive numbers, correct, and zero. Now how to represent negative numbers? For that we say that how to represent signed numbers. When you have sign, then how to represent them?